It's a beautiful Sunday morning, and I believe you are having yourself a great time. My name is Timothy, and you are watching Rapture Ready. And today on the show, we want to start it off with a beautiful song coming in from Mali Music, and it's off his new album coming forth in 2014. And the song is Ready Aim. Enjoy.
Guess I had to go there. Guess I had to come here, yeah. I know where I'm from, but now I'm headed where I'm going, right? But there are powers in the air, you can't see them. And they have rockets and machine guns. And they're firing on my plane. But I say fire! Straight cause it's sideways. Trying to take water to a dry place. Trying to take hope where it ain't night. Trying to take low to a high place. Wanna make the shooter put the gun down. So a mother gets to hold the sun now. Wanna make the lame man run again. Make the blind man see the sun again. But all I hear is bang, bang, yeah, yeah. I don't think the pods really want that. Breathe it down my neck, always on my back. Got the guns out, but I see fire.
And I yelled fire. That was Mali Music with Ready Aim, and I believe that you have been blessed. Well, every week we pride in bringing before you people who are making a difference in society or people who are setting a standard, and this week is no exception. We want to bring before you the Cape Brothers on Funliners. How are you, Cape Brothers?
We're okay.
Okay, so yes. Why the name Cape Brothers and where are the capes?
That's funny.
Yeah.
The name Cape Brothers, particularly Cape, mm-hmm. It's not about the Cape and yeah. The Cape Town or Cape Verde or something like that.
Okay.
It's just a name extracted from the word a cappella.
Okay.
As far as the music we sing is concerned, we sing a cappella kind of music,
yeah.
A genre on its own. So we extract the word Cape from a cappella.
Ah, okay.
Yeah.
That was extremely creative. Other people would never do
of
that.
Of course, when you're singing a cappella music, you have to be extra creative.
Ah, okay.
Yeah.
So who are the Cape Brothers? If you could just introduce yourselves real quick so that the guys at home can get to know who you are.
Okay, by myself, I'm Shekanabo Nelson. I sing lead in the group.
Nicholas Mtesasira, I do sing tenor.
Ladies and gentlemen, Kauchi Isaac, I'm doing bass and bass guitar.
Ah, okay.
Yeah, it's Ellie Songs right over here. I do lead and sometimes the alto backups.
Oh, okay, cool. So, bassist, how do you handle the ladies screaming for you? Because the bass people usually have more attention. These lead singers always are at the front. But for you, you'll be there at the back, then just come in with like a low and then people just scream for you.
Actually, here, it becomes more pressureful, yeah, where they scream for you and then you lose focus and
you just get distracted,
you forget what to do, but with the help of God you go on and
yes.
Do your thing.
As the spirit leads on.
So you don't get distracted by the people who are screaming and
not much.
Ah, okay,
yeah.
And lead, how do you handle, because I believe to be a lead singer you must really have your vocals in check. What happens when you...
We always do practices. It is not that it just gets us by chance. We always do practices. We do voice trainings. We do rehearsals. So it keeps your voice up to date.
Ah, okay.
Yeah.
So when did the group start, the Cape Brothers? When did you come together and how did you begin?
The group started in 2008 with some other guys who are not here. Some of us are here. And we officially decided to put the music out to the world in 2010, 24th October.
Ah, 24th October. It was a memorable day.
Yeah.
So in 2008, where were you? Were you in school at the time?
We were still in school.
Mm-hmm. And how many were you in the beginning? Because you, I know you guys are a total of eight.
By that time, we were like six.
Six?
Yeah.
Okay.
And I decided to start this group because of the inspiration I got from the American groups who sing a cappella, like the Gaithers, like the Stamps Put It, like a lot of groups.
Okay.
Yeah.
Ah, okay. And how was it in school? Because I know that in school people can say, these guys are in a cappella, what?
Yeah.
There are guitars here, there is what? Why don't you guys pick up instruments and do your thing there?
We didn't want instruments. We wanted to express ourselves vocally.
Okay.
And by that time, it was really weird, and people weren't like welcoming the idea.
Yeah.
They didn't appreciate a cappella music by that time. But just because we had started, and the starting is not always easy.
Okay.
We had to have some time for blending our voices.
Yeah.
So that people start appreciating us.
Okay. You mentioned in the beginning you were six.
Yes.
And right now you are eight. Yeah. How did you come from six to eight? Have some members left the group? Have you got new members coming on?
You know, when you're starting something, there are those people who are focused and those people who want to do it just for fun.
Okay.
But for us, we were focused. We kept the group going.
Okay.
From six, we went to four.
Okay.
Four, that's the official starting.
Yeah.
Like the Cape Brothers Quartet.
Yeah. And you got the name Cape Brothers when you were four people.
Yeah, that was... Okay. No, we got the name way back in school.
Okay.
That was me, Nicholas, Isaac, and some other guy called Sam.
Okay.
Yeah.
Ah, okay. So, from that long time ago, I believe you guys have gone through a lot of challenges. How have you guys managed to keep together as a group? Because many people actually in school start out with a lot of passion and energy, but as time progresses, you find them slipping away and saying, you know what, I don't think this singing thing is going to work for me.
You know, it's all about this. The background of the Cape Brothers is Christian.
Okay.
We are a gospel group.
Yeah.
To keep the group going, you have to be prayerful about those challenges. So, we pray, we fellowship together.
Mm.
That keeps us going, however much we have challenges.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, what are some of the challenges that you guys have faced as a group together?
Well, they are mob.
Mm-hmm.
Like me, personally, we've faced misunderstandings with ourselves. And then facilitation out there.
Yeah.
You know, when people want to call you and go sing in church, they think you're going there for free.
Yeah.
Okay. It may be free, but still, it has some cost.
Yes. True.
And maybe the other challenge is timekeeping within us.
Okay.
You know, we're Africans. And we can't deny that fact.
Not all of you are African, we can see it and tell it. Yeah. When you introduced yourselves, the names showed.
Yeah.
What other challenges have you faced that really tested you as a group sticking together? Because I feel there are those challenges that come through. Maybe, I don't know what it is for you, but for other guys it can be babes, for other people it can be conflict of interest, or probably one person is more passionate than another. What really has tried you guys as a group?
We have a challenge of not appreciating what we do.
Okay.
People not appreciating what we do. When we came out, people were like, what are those people going to do? What's a cappella indeed?
Yeah.
You know? We had to prove that to them.
Okay.
By strongly doing a cappella.
Yeah.
And they've started appreciating and they're really loving it.
Okay.
Yeah.
As I've talked about appreciation, what are some of the places that you guys have performed at that have probably been very exciting and memorable?
First and foremost,
we've
went to Rakitura, the president's home.
Ah.
Yeah, we've been there last year.
Okay.
Even in the state house in Entebbe.
Wow.
The prayer that happens in December.
Yeah.
Thanksgiving prayers. Thanksgiving. We're always there.
Okay.
So, social media awards. We're the main artists.
You guys have just been genuine all around the place.
Yeah, we have to prove this. And we are not yet settled because that is small to us.
Ah, okay.
Yeah.
So let me ask, What was your first performance like as a group together? Or one of your first big performances, how was it like?
Well, I joined the group later, and the biggest performance I've ever seen with the Cape Brothers, I think, was when we went to the president's home in Rachitura. He was celebrating 40 years in marriage.
Yeah.
And I mean, it was such a big experience for me. And then when we went for the social media awards at Hub, Garden City, it was really a good experience for me.
Yeah.
The Cape Brothers, we had fun.
So you guys just had fun.
Yeah.
Is it possible for you to just give us like a small bit of that Cape Brothers feeling, so the guys at home can be able to just feel it a little bit?
All right. When I was still young, I used to disobey my daddy. But when I read the book of Proverbs,
amazing voices, amazing guys, and also an amazing family. Those were the Cape Brothers. It goes to show you that irrespective of what background you have, as long as you're united by a common cause, God will bind you together and you will surely do what you set out to achieve. But by now, let's take a break and we'll be right back with so much more.